If you're an indie developer, scrap that custom, whimsical design that makes your app so unique and special. That custom font, those custom controls with pretty animations, get that bullshit out of here. Look, indie dev is hard enough. We have like 30 different iPhone and iPad screen sizes. And if you want to support landscape on the iPhone, that's a whole nother thing. Do you want a Mac app? What about accessibility with dynamic type or in zoom mode? App development has become very complex over the past few years. Like, it's getting ridiculous. And as an indie dev, you're one, maybe two people. You have to take a look at where you're spending your time and what's the most impactful. And I think the first thing you should do is let Apple take the design load off your plate. Apple's design language is clean, minimal, and best of all, it's proven. Like, follow their lead. Apple's apps get out of the way and let the user do what they need to do. And that's great. Like, that's exactly what I'm going for with my app creator view. The best compliment someone could give me is if they say, this feels like an Apple app. It just feels like it belongs natively on the platforms. And if you're not on board with this idea, consider these points. Design skills. You're probably not that good. If you're an indie dev, there's like a 95% chance you're not gonna get back a positive ROI on all that time you spend on your custom design. And even if you think you'll save that time by outsourcing it to a professional designer, is it really worth the cost and the mental overhead of like managing that designer, approving designs, and then what about ongoing design work when you have a new feature and all that stuff? Like, is it worth it? Now, of course, nothing is absolute. If the main differentiator for your app is that custom whimsical design, like think of the not boring series of apps or maybe Carrot Weather, then yeah, of course, like this message isn't for you. This message is for the other 95% of apps that think they need a custom design, but don't, and they spend a lot of time and resources making that custom design. And then there's the Apple platform's evolution and changes, right? Nowadays, users are expecting an app to be on the iPhone, the iPad, the watch, the Mac. And Swift native components are built for this, right? Like a form is gonna look like a form should on a watch or a phone. Same thing with, you know, like a date picker, segmented controls, SF symbols. And by using those default components, when Apple's design language, you know, changes and evolves, you just evolve with them for pretty much free. Like some examples are recently, I think iOS 15, they changed the default look of list to inset grouped. Well, you got that for free if you're using default lists. Or maybe the transparent tab bar, I think that was new in iOS 15 too. If you're using the default tab bar, not your own custom thing, you got that for free too. So by using the default components, you evolve with Apple as they inevitably change. But anyway, my point is, as an indie dev, you have so much on your plate. You're better off spending all that time you would have spent on a custom design on sales and marketing. That's really my whole point. Of all the things you have to do, I just believe a custom design, again, unless it's the main differentiator for your app, is not the best use of your time, money, and resources. And now that you have this extra time, you can focus on monetizing your app via subscriptions or in-app purchases. And if you wrote all that store kit code yourself, whew, I recommend letting the pros do it because there are a ton of edge cases and weird situations that are very hard to handle for a singular indie dev. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Glassfy. Glassfy is a ridiculously flexible app revenue management platform that helps engineering and growth teams generate predictable revenue streams from their apps. Glassfy takes a platform approach with various solutions natively built in, like those subscriptions and in-app purchases I was talking about for iOS, Android, and web. I use them to implement that in CreatorView, my app, and the setup was a breeze. It also has revenue growth tools such as rich analytics, paywalls, and redemption codes so teams can use data to make better decisions to generate revenue all within the Glassfy platform. So whether you're adding revenue to an existing app or replacing your current setup, Glassfy will help engineering and growth teams deliver better on their revenue growth goals.